too.
Okay, everybody ready?
Oh, I like that. Thank you. It's
whatever they are. Gary?
Jane, good morning.
Hi.
It's very nice to have a chance to talk with you, having seen you in the movie, The Lover, and knowing, of course, that it's your motion picture debut. Mm-hmm. You had never done even the slightest thing on film before?
A couple of television commercials, but I won't go into that. No, nothing, really.
It is just a phenomenal performance. It really is.
Thank you.
The most experienced actress, I'm sure, would say that it's a very challenging role.
It was.
And here you are, someone who doesn't even know the motion picture business or the technique or anything, having to do this role.
Mm.
Was there ever a point, Jane, when you thought you were in over your head and saying, I have to get out of here, I can't do this?
Yeah, a lot of the time, from beginning to start, you know, because all of it was a big experience for me. It was a new experience, going to Vietnam, doing this movie, acting, 17 years old, first time in Asia. A lot of responsibility. And from day one, I was a nervous wreck about it, especially with the love scenes. I mean, they were a very big contribution to the movie. But we shot in Vietnam for 5 months prior. So that kind of prepared us for that. But I really needed Jean-Jacques. I needed confidence. It's true, I didn't know a thing about the motion picture industry. And I couldn't believe that all these people were on this set for me, for this film. All of it was very shocking, very surprising, and I learned a lot from it, too.
The very first time you talked with the director, Jean-Jacques Annaud, what did he say to you? What did you all talk about?
Well, it was my 17th birthday, and when I told them that, I didn't mean to tell them. I can't remember how we got into this. He said, when were you born? I said, blah, blah, and he said, oh, it's your birthday today, and the next thing I know, I've got a glass of champagne in my hand and a present in the other, and I'm like, this isn't usual for a casting. It was kind of strange, and he wanted to know about me as a person. And normally when you do a casting, you just go in, give your pictures, thank you, goodbye. And I really thought maybe I was onto something here. But only when I'd read the book did I really want to do this. And then the script came in, parts of the script, and then we did the screen tests. And I really wanted this part so badly. Because it is a very challenging part, and it was a great challenge for me. I wanted to see if I could do it.
Did you discuss it with your parents? I assume you have mother and father living?
Yeah.
Yes. Mm. Did you discuss it with your parents and ask them what they thought about your doing this kind of role, sexuality, nudity, the whole thing?
I don't ever remember saying, Mom, is it okay if I do it? Because nobody would have stopped me doing the part. So it was never a point of discussion. The point of discussion wasn't even discussion. Mom, I'm nervous. Mom, I don't want to do it. Mom, I can't do it. And my mom and dad would be like, well, you know, only do it if you feel like doing it. And that was always their motto, even if I had an exam to do. So nobody would have kept me away from this film. I wanted to do it, so that was the main thing.
When you would film the love scenes, they're very explicit. It requires you to be totally nude.
Yeah.
What was the strength that got you through it? How did you get through it?
Probably my anxiety, and I was very nervous about doing it. I wasn't sleeping for weeks. And I think that nervous energy really helped, because I don't know where else it could have come from. I felt drained. I didn't want to do the scenes. Nobody wanted to shoot them. It was a cold studio in Paris. I mean, you know, it's not something you can rehearse either. And you come on the set, your robe, and you go on the set and you do it, and afterwards you get into your robe and you go back to your dressing room and you cry. And you just don't want tomorrow to come. You don't want to have to do another scene, but you want to get them over as soon as possible. But on the other hand, I wouldn't have done them if I hadn't thought they were necessary, and they are very necessary in the film. And what I was really, you know, what surprised me in this script was that there was no violence, and it was pure love. And I think that's what a lot of people weren't used to, and I wasn't used to seeing it, and I couldn't imagine it on the screen because people aren't used to that kind of a movie. But that got me through it because I knew the scenes were there for a reason. I knew my character, and everybody knew their place, so we'd had time.
Was she an opportunistic girl, or how do you see her, Jane?
Yes, I think she is, and, you know, there's not one thing I can say. She's grown up in Saigon. They've been outcast by the whites, you know, the colonials, and and they're almost Vietnamese, which is an insult in those days. This young girl isn't a typical 1927 girl. She's slightly more advanced for her age. So she's not going through things our other friends are going through. She's kind of on her own. She's always on her own. She had a father who died when she was young, who left the family bad land. So they lost their money. The mother's slightly crazy and doesn't know why she doesn't love her daughter. The young girl is mystified by this because the mother doesn't know, and she tells her why she doesn't love her. I mean, it's very sad. An older brother who's an opium addict, a younger brother, autistic, and she's always had to put up with this, so she's building walls to defend herself against this. She's just defending herself like any young child, being defensive and always tough and never showing her feelings. And when she starts the affair with the Chinaman, she's very uppity, and she's the leading one, not only because she's white, because in those days that was a big factor, but because she knew he was scared of her and she could sense his weakness and she preyed on it. And she took his money, she used him, but at the same time she's the one that was hurt. She's the one that kicked herself because she did love him in the end. And it was really about puberty, about discovering yourself. Like any young girl, you feel desire or you want to experiment on something. And that's what I loved about her, because she wasn't the one being seduced. She was the one seducing. She was the one leading everything.
But in the end, then, you think she loved him very much?
She loved him anyway, but she didn't realize it till the end. Like, after the marriage, she comes back to the house and says, "Do you only see him for the money?" And she really thinks about it. And things are sort of, maybe something's wrong here. And then when she hears their music, she's going back to France. She knows she'll never see him again. It's just the most beautiful scene. And of course, she's upset because she really did love him.
Jane, I again congratulate you on your performance.
Thank you.
I'm sure that we're going to see you in many more films.
Thanks very much.
Thanks for talking with us today here in New York City.
Thank you.
So lovely. Oh, I have one.
I bet you do. I bet she's got one.
I got a couple.
Okay, everybody ready?
Yes. Oh, I like those shoes.
Thank you.
It's whatever they are.
Harry?
Begin. Jane, good morning.
Hi.
It's very nice to have a chance to talk with you, having seen you in the movie, The Lover, and knowing, of course, that it's your motion picture debut. Mm-hmm. You had never done even the slightest thing on film before?
A couple of television commercials, but I won't go into that. No, nothing, really.
It is just a phenomenal performance. It really is. The most experienced actress, I'm sure, would say that it's a very challenging role.
It was.
And here you are, someone who doesn't even know the motion picture business or the technique or anything, having to do this role. Mm. Was there ever a point, Jane, when you thought you were in over your head and saying, I have to get out of here, I can't do this?
Yeah, a lot of the time, from beginning to start. Because all of it was a big experience for me, it was a new experience, going to Vietnam, doing this movie, acting, 17 years old, first time in Asia. A lot of responsibility, and from day one I was a nervous wreck about it, especially with the love scenes. I mean, they were very big contribution to the movie. But we shot in Vietnam for 5 months prior, so that kind of prepared us for that. But I really needed Jean-Jacques, I needed confidence. It's true, I didn't know a thing about the motion picture industry, and I couldn't believe that all these people were on this set for me, for this film. All of it was very shocking, very surprising, and I learned a lot from it, too.
The very first time you talked with the director, Jean-Jacques Annaud, what did he say to you? What did you all talk about?
Well, it was my 17th birthday, and when I told them that, I didn't mean to tell them. I can't remember how we got into this. He said, "When were you born?" I said, "Blah, blah." And he said, "Oh, it's your birthday today." And the next thing I know, I've got a glass of champagne in my hand and a present in the other, and I'm like, this isn't usual for a casting. It was kind of strange, and he wanted to know about me as a person. And normally when you do a casting, you just go in, give your pictures, thank you, goodbye. And I really thought maybe I was onto something here. Only when I'd read the book did I really want to do this. And then the script came in, parts of the script, and then we did the screen tests. And I really wanted this part so badly. Because it is a very challenging part, and it was a great challenge for me. I wanted to see if I could do it.
Did you discuss it with your parents? I assume you have mother and father living?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm.
Did you discuss it with your parents and ask them what they thought about your doing this kind of role, sexuality, nudity, the whole thing?
I don't ever remember saying, "Mom, is it okay if I do it?" Because nobody would have stopped me doing the part. So it was never a point of discussion. The point of discussion wasn't even discussion. "Mom, I'm nervous. Mom, I don't want to do it. Mom, I can't do it." And my mom and dad would be like, "Well, you know, only do it if you feel like doing it." And that was always their motto, even if I had an exam to do. So nobody would have kept me away from this film. I wanted to do it, so that was the main thing.
When you would film the love scenes, they're very explicit. It requires you to be totally nude.
Yeah.
What was the strength that got you through it? How did you get through it?
Probably my anxiety, and I was very nervous about doing it. I wasn't sleeping for weeks. And I think that nervous energy really helped, because I don't know where else it could have come from. I felt drained. I didn't want to do the scenes. Nobody wanted to shoot them. It was a cold studio in Paris. I mean, you know, it's not something you can rehearse either. And you come on the set, your robe, and you go on the set and you do it, and afterwards you get into your robe and you go back to your dressing room and you cry. And you just don't want tomorrow to come. You don't want to have to do another scene, but you want to get them over as soon as possible. But on the other hand, I wouldn't have done them if I hadn't thought they were necessary, and they are very necessary in the film. And what I was really, you know, what surprised me in this script was that there was no violence, and it was pure love. And I think that's what a lot of people weren't used to, and I wasn't used to seeing it, and I couldn't imagine it on the screen, because people aren't used to that kind of a movie. But that got me through it, because I knew the scenes were there for a reason. I knew my character, and everybody knew their place, so we'd had time.
Was she an opportunistic girl, or how do you see her, Jane?
Yes, I think she is, and, you know, there's not one thing I can say. And she's grown up in Saigon. They've been outcast by the whites, you know, the colonials, and they're almost Vietnamese, which is an insult in those days. This young girl isn't a typical 1927 girl. She's slightly more advanced for her age. So she's not going through things our other friends are going through. She's kind of on her own. She's always on her own. She had a father who died when she was young, who left the family bad land. So they lost their money. The mother's slightly crazy and doesn't know why she doesn't love her daughter. The young girl is mystified by this because the mother doesn't know, and she tells her why she doesn't love her. I mean, it's very sad. An older brother who's an opium addict, a younger brother, autistic. And she's always had to put up with this, so she's building walls to defend herself against this. She's just defending herself like any young child, being defensive and always tough and never showing her feelings. And when she starts the affair with the Chinaman, she's very uppity, and she's the leading one, not only because she's white, because in those days that was a big factor, but because she knew he was scared of her, and she could sense his weakness, and she preyed on it. And she took his money, she used him, but at the same time, she's the one that was hurt. She's the one that kicked herself, because she did love him in the end. And it was really about puberty, about discovering yourself. Like any young girl, you feel desire, or you want to experiment on something. And that's what I loved about her, because she wasn't the one being seduced, she was the one seducing. She was the one leading everything.
But in the end, then, you think she loved him very much?
She loved him anyway, but she didn't realize it till the end. Like after the marriage, she comes back to the house and mother says, "Do you only see him for the money?" And she really thinks about it. And things are sort of, maybe something's wrong here. And then when she hears their music, she's going back to France, she knows she'll never see him again. It's just the most beautiful scene. And of course, she's upset because she really did love him.
Jane, I again congratulate you on your performance.
Thank you.
I'm sure that we're going to see you in many more films.
Thanks very much.
Thanks for talking with us today here in New York City.
Thank you.
So lovely.